Hey, all you RVC fans, I just wanted to show you where do you put your models when you're using voice changer. So you want to locate your folder. You want to scroll down to where it says model_dir or model directory. Double click on it. And all these folders from 0 to 9, which makes 10, you can have all your RVC models, and you either have copied over from an old installation of the program or all the files that you have installed using the GUI interface of voice changer itself. So I'll show you where exactly these are. I'll launch my program and we'll take a look at. So you want to find your start_http.bat, and you want to just double click on that and wait for it to load. This takes sometimes longer than I think it should, but I don't know exactly like what it does. All right, guys, thanks for waiting. I had a little hiccup. I don't know why it failed. First time I tried, but I'm back online. So right here, as you can see, all 10 of the voices that I currently have. These are either models that I downloaded, which is the majority of them. This is from our first tutorial, or second, I'm not too sure. And these two I created. So when you go to edit, and anytime you see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that correlates with all the files inside of your model directory. So that's your 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So as you can tell, inside here, I actually have two characters because I didn't delete the original that it came with, which is this character. I don't know if you can see it. That character. But on this tutorial that I did, I haven't changed it back. I have James Rolfe. And I showed how to add his voice to the voice changer, which is here. Now I'm gonna change it back to the original. Just gonna upload it, find the file, model directory, 0, and what you wanna load is the Onyx file. And I'm just gonna upload that. And for the image, same thing, let's find our image, close, and the character's there. So, if you load it up, there's your character. And right now I don't have any microphone installed. So I'm using it to record this. And that is how you change any character you want to use in the voice changer. And you'll find the files here inside of your model DIR. Hope that helps. Quick side note, if you ever lose the default voice models that you wanted to use inside a voice changer, you can always visit this website. I'll put the link below. And from here, you'll find all the 5 original voice models that came with voice changer. I know Amitaru possibly was one of them that didn't show up by default. You had to load it in, but it's fine. You could find them here. You want to look for the Onyx version of it. You could always go for the PTH and the index file, which is usually the file with the longer name on it. But you're eventually gonna probably wanna make an Onyx file anyway, so might as well just download that and use that file. So all five of them are here. It's all the same thing. You can find the Onyx. It's usually prefaced with the word simple in front of it, I believe. And that's your index with the longer path name. You can also download the PNG so you could have a photo you can put. And so they're all here, I believe. And another thing with w-okada voice changer, if you need to find the voice changer, you go to this website and scroll all the way down, and then once you get to here, which says download here, you want to choose either your Mac or your Windows. And I usually don't use Google because when I do, it says it's busy. So it's, yeah, get this error message, which throws most people off these days. But what you want to do is choose the Hugging Face link. The Hugging Face link will lead you to this page. URL up here. And usually, it's probably the bottom folder. You can see when it was last updated. This is updated 12 days ago. And you just click on this, and it'll go to this page. You can read about, you know, security on it. You can read its gigabyte size, remote size, pointer size. And then you just click on here, click on download. And it'll start downloading for you. That's it. Hope that helps. Take care. I'm joking. I'm not finished yet. So once you do have all your stuff loaded in, you have all your models, you wanna do all that stuff, you need to separate your vocals for your songs. So I would recommend this free app. You can do maybe 12 minutes of free vocal removal, I think like every couple hours or so. You can also pay for it if you wanted to get more stems. I don't know if this is gonna work with my MP4. So if it processes properly, you'll get a couple of stems. I have backing vocal remove on. You turn it off if you want to keep the backing vocals as well. This doesn't seem to change the backing vocal removal very well, but hey, this is what we have. So this is I think the bottom one is your vocals. But once you do, just click on download vocals. Screen would flash, download your vocals. You want to download the instrument, same thing. And you have your files. It's that easy for this program. And locate files, do what you need to do with them. Bring them into Easy GUI, do your cover songs, bring into your DAW, edit it, what you like. Hope that helped.